Senhora, em julgar a Senhora.
Thank you, Sri Charan, Sumit, Merlin, and everyone for waiting. A couple of weeks back, I was at a family reunion where all our cousins, aunts, uncles had met. And we were all playing. And I saw two of my younger cousins, aged about 7 or 8, running out of the room, shouting at each other. One of them said, "I don't want to talk to you anymore." And the other said, "I don't care. You're not my friend. Like, you broke my toy. I told you not to play with it." And they were shouting at each other. And one of them even said, "I hate you. I don't want to be friend anymore." And both ran to their mothers, complaining about each other. And their mothers sorted it out between them. So it turns out one of them had stolen the toy of the other and dropped it, and it had broken. And he came and apologized to her. And 15 minutes later, believe it or not, they were back together playing like best friends. Now this got me thinking, what if the same thing had happened with us adults? If someone comes and tells me, "I don't like you, I don't want to talk to you," or "you're dumb, you're not good," anything, and even if they apologize 100 times after that, I wouldn't be the same with them. I would start thinking that they have some ulterior motive, they need something from me. And this helped me realize the difference between children and adults is how to deal with conflicts. Somewhere along the lines of growing up, we forget how to deal with it. Children face conflicts head on, something we fail to do as adults. Let's see. Now, the reason for this is that we don't realize what the other person needs. We try to win every argument, every fight, just because we want to win it. Let me tell you, a conflict cannot be won. It needs to be resolved. Winning a conflict is even grammatically incorrect. So this brings me to one of the activities I played in school that relates well with this conflict resolution, and I'd like to share that with you. So there was a small kingdom where a special type of oranges were grown. Let's call this the kingdom of Orange Land. And the orange, the rare species of orange, is called rare oranges. The people of this kingdom were not very creative with names, much like myself. And the king of that kingdom would have a limited supply of oranges every year and would sell it to the highest bidder. And this year, there were two countries fighting for it, both with their own problems, Crisis Land 1, Crisis Land 2. Now, Crisis Land 1 had intel that there was an imminent chemical attack on their country, and the only way to neutralize this is through extracting the serum from this orange and producing the anti-chemical. And Crisis Land 2 was dealing with an epidemic which was affecting the infants. And the only way to cure this was, again, you guessed it right, through these oranges. So the government of these countries sent their best negotiators to convince the other country to not stop, to stop them from buying the oranges for themselves, because each of them needed all the oranges from the kingdom of Orange Land. So these two negotiators faced off with each other, and one after the other they started putting logic that this, they went all in. One of them told, "Children are being affected, it's more important than your threat. We don't even know if it's real." The other said, "But if it's real, it's going to impact much larger audience. We need the oranges, we need the oranges." And there was no resolution. So as every story has it, they went to the wise old man. And this wise old man asked them, observed their case, and asked them, "What do you want?" One of them said, "I want the oranges." The other said, "I want the oranges." And he asked them, "What do you think the other person wants?" Both of them again told, "They want the oranges. They want the oranges." And upon closer observation, he realized that Chrysostom 1 needed to extract the serum from the orange seeds, and the Chrysostom 2, to avoid the epidemic, needed to extract the serum from orange peels, the peel of the orange.
Oh.
So he told them, why don't you just buy the orange, keep the seeds for yourself, give them the peel. Problem solved. Such a simple resolution, and the best negotiators of both those countries couldn't think of this. Why? Because everybody wanted the orange. Nobody thought about what they needed or what the other person needed. Now, tying this back to how we deal with conflicts, we always try to win no matter what. We want to get what we want without realizing it may not be what we need. And if we just understand what we need and what the other party needs, we'll be much better off for it. And why do children understand this and adults don't? It's because adults confuse conflicts with debates. Yes. A debate is about the topic, whereas a conflict is about the people. A debate can be won, but a conflict should be resolved. A debate ends with one or more than one party changing their state of mind, whereas a conflict ends with both the parties returning to their original state of mind. And once we realize this, we'll be able to handle conflicts much better. Because as philosopher Jagger once said, you don't always get what you want, but if you try, sometimes you get what you need. And as growing up, we forget this inborn quality that was with us. And we need to keep reminding ourselves that we need to understand what the other person and we need. While we always want the orange, maybe all we need is the seed or the peel, and still have the fruit to make juice with it. So let us relearn what we've forgotten. So I want you all to say this with me and fill in the blank. A conflict cannot be won. It needs to be
resolved.
Exactly. Over to you.